My name is Raymond Heron, and my wife and I own and run Spoinkop Lodge. I established Spoinkop Lodge 22 years ago with my wife in order to be able to talk to them, to people from around the world about South African history, because I find South African history fascinating. And I spent all my formative years in what was known as Northern Rhodesia, which became Zambia. And I came to live in South Africa in 1968.
What we do here at Spoinkop, we have offer boat cruises, we offer battlefield tours, the mornings and the afternoon. We offer game drives in the nature reserve, which is adjacent to us.
My name is Jabu. I freelance on doing a tourism guide in here in the area. We are right now in Spoinkop Nature Reserve, where we are now with Spoinkop Dam. It's a dam, actually, it's just that the water is down because of no rain at this time. This area is called Venterspruit. It's situated right on the other side of the Spoinkop Dam towards the Bergville area. And it has a lot of animals around us. We've seen some white rhinos and elands and some hartebeests. It's quite a popular area for nature lovers to cruise on the boat and come here and then stop by and take some photos from the boat onto the land.
We are here at a place called Talana Museum, which is actually a battle site, which is part of the Anglo-Boer War. And inside the museum, it's divided into different parts with different exhibitions. We've just gone through one of the lovely, magnificent exhibition, because here we had a company called Consol, which produces glass, and they were showing us different art made out of glass. And of course, you also see part of the museum. You see the cultural part of the Boers as well as the Zulus. My passion is culture. I love different cultures. It excites me because that is how I learn about different people. Now I have a mix. What I'm wearing is a mix of cultures. I've got the Ndebele culture, which you see through my what I have here. But also the Zulus used to wear this, and we called it upseng, which is very old. The old ladies used to wear it here and also on our feet. And then I have the Ndebele print, which is part of my skirt. Ndebele is well known for their artistic and very colorful art. And then I have the Zulu beads. Zulus used colors of the beads to actually send messages. Of course, now we use it for decorative purposes, just to make ourselves look beautiful.
Which is a rural school, and we do a huge amount of development for that school. We have the people that have come in from overseas, and that we've put in 21 computers. And during COVID, these children, our rural children, have really benefited from the support we've had from our international guests. We have so far given out 575 food parcels, and they continue to support the children. So we, with tourism, goes education. As far as we're concerned, it's time for us to assist rural education to be uplifted, which us being in this area certainly has had an impact on.